Hi folks, in this video I want to talk how to optimize this TCO, this transparent conducting oxide, which as we discussed is often used in these thin film based solar cell. So to understand how to optimize it and you know what should be the optimal features of this TCO material, it's important to understand how these thin film solar cell are made. And I find that quite fascinating, you know, how these thin film solar cells are made. So let me give you one example, and I'll give you an example of a case where these solar cells are made in a superstrate configuration. So in those cases, you start with essentially a piece of glass. So this is a large piece of glass drawn over here. So this glass, of course, is not conducting material. So you can't use the glass itself as an electrode. So what is done is that you first deposit, the very first film you deposit is a film of this TCO material, which forms one of your electrodes. So this is your TCO material. Now, a very thing I find very fascinating, and that is unique to these thin film based solar design, is that the way you form these different cells. So this is a big piece of glass. It could be, you know, all the way from 1 meter to a couple of meters long. So how do you form these individual cells in this panel? So one way would be to, of course, to essentially break this glass into multiple pieces and make individual cells. But you can see that wouldn't be very efficient because you know it's not very. First of all, it won't be very easy to cut this glass into very small pieces. Plus, your yield will go down, and there's some other reasons where it would become difficult as well. So, you know, there's a neat way to essentially make different cells on this single piece of glass. And the process which is used to do so is laser scribing. So what is done is that you essentially scribe this TCO layer into using a laser, and you form these individual islands of this TCO material. And this is what essentially forms your different cells. And these cells are series connected, again, in a very intelligent fashion that I'll just describe. So the very first thing you do is essentially scribe this TCO layer. Now, the next thing which is done is you deposit your absorber material. So you essentially deposit your absorber material, which is your thin film, which will absorb the light. So it will deposit everywhere. It will deposit on top of your TCO material. It will essentially also deposit like over here in between the scribes that you made in your TCO material. So this is your absorber layer over here. Now this could be different depending upon different thin film technologies. For example, if you're using amorphous silicon based solar cell, this would be made out of amorphous silicon. If you are using a cadtel technology, this absorber material would be cadmium telluride, and so on. But I'm just denoting it as a generic absorber material over here. Now, the next thing you do is essentially scribe this absorber material again. So you bring on your laser and essentially scribe this absorber material using a laser as well. And these again, you form islands of these absorber materials, and they are separated from each other. So now you can see that you know each of these is an individual cell. So this is my cell one over here, which has this this electrode at the bottom, and then it has this absorber material. And then I have this other material over here, which has this electrode and this absorber material over here. But you can see these cells are so far not connected. The electrodes are still separated from each other. So now what is done is that you essentially deposit a second layer of TCO material. So you come back and deposit this second layer of TCO material. And of course, this will deposit everywhere as well. So it would actually, let me strike the other way around. So now this will deposit everywhere as well. It will deposit not only on top of this absorber material, but it will also deposit in these trenches which were formed by these laser scribes. And as you might have guessed, again, the thing I'm going to do next is essentially scribe this top TCO material as well. So this was my top TCO material. And so this would be TCO2. And let me call it the first one TCO1. So now what I'll do is essentially scribe this TCO2 as well. And so now essentially I can see my structure or my skeleton of my cell forming. And let me show you how. So now I've scribed this top TCO material as well. And they are now essentially separated using these laser scribes as well. But in the process, another thing I've done is that I've series connected these cells. So let me show you how. So this is my first cell. So this is my first cell. This is my bottom electrode. This is my absorber material. And this is my top electrode over here. Now, since I deposited this TCO everywhere, it is now essentially, you can see it's connecting to this bottom of this other cell over here. So if this cell was of, let's say, a PN junction over here, where the bottom part is P and the top part is N. Now this N layer is connecting to the P layer of this second cell. So now you can see that since this top TCO, this TCO2, is touching this TCO1, now you see that there's a series connection which is forming between these cells. Similarly over here, you see that this is my second cell. So this is the P and N. And then the N region of this cell is now connected via this laser scribe opening over here. It's connected to this third cell at the TC of the third cell over here. So what I have essentially now formed is these PN junctions, which are connected in series with each other. So I can think of each of these cells. Essentially, this is a PN cell, and this is now connected to this second cell over here through this connection, which is now connected to this third cell over here using this connection between these two TCO materials. So this is how a thin film based solar cell is made. And I find it, you know, very neat way to essentially make this series connect all these solar cells. But it comes with some challenges. And one of the main challenges over here is that since I'm using multiple of these laser scribes, so I'm using three of these laser scribes, as you can see over here. So this was my first laser scribe, this was my second laser scribe, and this was my third laser scribe. So I'm using three laser scribe process over here. In these three laser scribe processes, they're only very roughly aligned to each other. So there's no lithographic patterning or anything going on over here. Only way these laser scribes are aligned is optical alignment. And that essentially, you know, requires you to leave quite a bit of spacing between each of these laser scribes. So essentially, if I think about this region, which is in between these three laser scribes, that essentially is the width of this region is, you know, typically hundreds of micron in usual cells. So, and also this region is not contributing to any solar energy conversion, or this is not essentially being part of a cell. So this constitute what is the dead region, which is called as often the dead region in my cell. And its width is denoted by, I'm denoting over here by this symbol WD over here. So if you're a solar cell manufacturer, you essentially, you know, want to minimize the fraction of this dead region. So let's say this is my dead region and this is my actual cell. So I want to minimize the fraction of this width of the dead region versus the width of my cell. So essentially I want to minimize, or I want to essentially minimize this fraction, which is WD by W. So WD would be, you know, fixed by how precisely I can align these different scribes. So essentially a way to reduce this fraction would be to essentially maximize my cell width. So if I can make each of these cells very wide, the contribution due to this or the no contribution due to this dead region, it becomes insignificant.